If you want to get back together with your ex, there's a number of things that you should never say to them. And some of them are actually totally counterintuitive. But don't worry, because that's exactly what I'll be covering right here in this video. Now, how do I know what you should and you shouldn't say to your ex to win them back? Well, my name is Brad Browning, or Breakup Brad, and I've been a leading breakup coach for well over a decade now. I'm also author of The X Factor, a comprehensive guide to getting your ex back. And my program has helped over 130,000 clients get a second chance at love, and my videos here on YouTube have been viewed over 54 million times. So it's safe to say that breakups are what I do. Now, let's talk about what you should not say to your ex if you want to win them back. And by the way, when this video is over, please vote in the poll up here in the corner and let me know if you've already said any of the things that I'm going to cover in this video to your ex. So when the video is over, just click that little icon in the top right and vote yes or no. Okay, so the first thing that you should never say to your ex is, I'm still in love with you. Now, yes, I know this might be the case. Maybe you're still madly in love with your ex. I mean, you're watching this video right now after all. But if you do want them back, you can't let them know that. I promise you that your chances will be significantly higher if you hide your true intentions from your ex. And while you may think that saying something like this is a nice gesture that's going to melt your ex's heart, it's actually psychologically proven that saying, I still love you to your ex is only going to push them further away. Second thing you should never say to your ex is, I miss you. Again, this is really similar to saying, I'm still in love with you. It tells your ex that you're struggling with the breakup, you're not over him or her, and you're probably wanting to get back together. And although all of this is probably true, it's definitely not what you want your ex to be thinking. And number three, I'm so lonely and depressed since we broke up. Now, playing the sympathy card is definitely not going to do you any good, nor is it going to make your ex want to take you back. I mean, do you really think that if your ex knows you haven't eaten or slept in 3 days, that that's going to make them more attracted to you or make them want to take you back? Really, all it's doing is making you sound rather pathetic. So what you really need to do is show your ex that you're a high-value individual, that you're moving on with life and you're not waiting around wallowing in your own sorrow. Now, if you've already said something like this and made it clear to your ex how much heartache the breakup has actually already caused you, then employing my no-contact strategy for at least a few weeks is going to be key to resetting your ex's feelings about you. And the fourth thing you should never say is, I hate you, or I never should have dated you. Look, feeling a sense of anger and resentment towards your ex is a natural reaction to being dumped. I mean, this is especially true if there was a lot of hostility and hard feelings during the final days of your relationship. And I totally understand why some people want to vent their anger and lash out at their ex. But let me just make this one thing clear. Being mean to your ex or insulting them is never going to help your situation. Ever. I mean, think about it. If you want your ex back, then it's obvious that getting angry at him or her isn't going to help your cause. At best, it makes you seem petty, and at worst, it'll just confirm that he or she made the right decision in dumping you. And even if you decide that you don't want to get back together, I mean, what is lashing out and being mean really going to accomplish? It might make you feel better briefly, but you're going to get more satisfaction from moving on and thriving without your ex around. So suffice to say that getting angry or being mean to your ex just isn't a wise idea, regardless of the situation. Okay, I've now listed 4 things that you shouldn't say to your ex, and I've got a few more that I'm going to be explaining shortly. But if you've already said one of the 4 things I just covered to your ex, then just click on the little icon in the top right corner and vote yes in the poll. If not, if you haven't said any of those things to your ex, great job. And keep watching, because we're moving on to number 5 now. And number 5 is, never talk to me ever again. Okay, so I think this one is pretty evident, but I need to mention it because I've had a number of clients say this to their ex for one reason or another. And obviously, you don't want or need to say this kind of thing to them regardless of your situation. If you say this to your ex and they have no interest in rekindling your romance, well, you run the risk of that actually having that happen, right? And after your breakup, you shouldn't be talking to your ex at all for a certain period of time. But this really isn't the way to initiate a period of no contact. Instead, just try to be polite and cordial by saying something like, you're right, some time apart might be a good idea. Or better yet, just initiate your period of no contact without actually saying anything to your ex at all. It's usually really not necessary. And the 6th thing you should never say to your ex is, I'm deleting you from Facebook and Instagram. Now, I don't recommend doing this at all, let alone actually telling your ex that you plan to do so. You can simply, you know, mute your ex on most social media platforms to ensure that you don't see their posts and their status updates in your newsfeed. So there's no reason to completely delete or unfriend them. And by actually telling your ex that you plan to unfollow or delete them from Facebook and Instagram, you're essentially saying to your ex that the very thought of them is causing you so much heartache that you want to just eliminate them from your life. And while separating yourself from your ex after the breakup is very important, you shouldn't be making it obvious to your ex that you're doing so. Remember, you need to show your ex that you don't need them and that you're not fazed by the breakup. And if you are truly unfazed by the breakup, then why would you bother deleting them from social media? Number 7, I promise I'll change if you'll just give me another chance. Ah, yes, begging and pleading with the promise of change. This is one of the worst things that you can say to your ex if you want them back. Again, as I've already mentioned, you want your ex to think that you're moving on and thriving in life since the breakup, and you don't want them to know that you're actively trying to win them back. Now, look, if you've already said this kind of thing to your ex, please consider signing up for my one-on-one coaching program as soon as possible to ensure that you don't make any more mistakes that could kill your chances for good. You can learn more about my personal coaching at breakupbrad.com/coaching. Before we move on, I should mention that sometimes change is necessary if you're going to get back together and have a successful, lasting relationship again, but begging and pleading with your ex is one of the worst things you can do if you want them back. And the eighth thing you should never say to your ex is, can we still be friends? Now, guys, I've said this before in previous videos, but I'll repeat it here again. You do not want to be friends with your ex if you're trying to get back together. First of all, suggesting this to your ex is another way of saying, but I still want you in my life. I can't live without you. And that really isn't the kind of message that you want to be sending to your ex if you're trying to win them back. You need to instill a sense of urgency and fear in their mind by forcing them to learn to live without you, and being friends with them will only do the opposite. Now, I have already made a video on this very topic previously, which you can watch now by clicking on the little pop-up banner in the top right or clicking the link in the description below. All right, folks, that's eight things that you should never say to your ex if you're trying to get them back. Let's quickly review all eight. Number one, I still love you. Number two, I miss you. Number three, I've been so lonely and depressed since we broke up. Number four, I hate you or I never should have dated you. Number five, never talk to me again. Number six, I'm deleting you from social media. Number seven, I promise to change if you'll give me another chance. And number eight, can we still be friends? Now, please take a quick second to vote in that poll and let me know if you've already said any of these eight things to your ex. Just click that little icon in the top right and choose yes or no. And if you want to find out your chances of getting back together and whether you've still got a shot at winning them back, just go to breakupbrad.com/quiz and take my free quiz. That's it for now, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for watching and we'll see you soon.